So the fifth week of the Rugby Championship is not too far away. This time we kick off in South Africa with the Wallabies travelling there. I mean, the win records of these teams at the minute in the Rugby Championship is Boxer 2-2. Their record, by everyone's accounts before that last game, was going to be the same as the Wallabies, which is only the 1-3. But the Boxer are coming off a very big win over the All Blacks in New Zealand. So they're very much kind of a team on the up at the moment. And the Wallabies, having lost at home to Argentina for the first time in like 35 years, kind of hitting a new low. So there is definitely pressure on both teams. This one's in Port Elizabeth, so altitude shouldn't be a factor. And, you know, both teams have had the week off to kind of prepare. So hopefully we'll see some kind of rejuvenated bodies after... Well, for the Box, a pretty Herculean effort against the All Blacks, and hopefully the Wallabies have had a chance to kind of reinvigorate themselves, re-motivate themselves after, like, it was a pretty somber mood after the Argentinian game. So, the Wallabies one win. It doesn't look great being 1-3, but that one win was over the Box. It was 23-18 in Brisbane. So, that kind of has to give them a bit of confidence, if nothing else. The Box, at the moment, I still feel like they're a team that could beat anyone on their day, as evidenced by last week, but could potentially lose to anyone with evidence of, you know, losing games, although be it away to Australia and to Argentina. So it's going to be an interesting one to see which Bok team turns up and to see whether the Wallabies can find a kind of fire, because it hasn't really happened so far. I will put the teams in the description so you guys can have a look down there, but I'll go over a few of the kind of the changes and some key points. The Beast is starting this week, so Kitsoff is on the bench. They kind of do a swap, which they've been doing of late. I'm still a fan of Kitsoff starting, but hey man, the Beast is the Beast, and I'll give him his props to start that prop. Crucially, perhaps Warren Whiteley is injured. Now, I hadn't been that impressed with him in the Rugby Championship up until that last game against the All Blacks, where he was just a massive tackling machine and kind of a leader within that group. Try assist guy. So yeah, Sukumbuza Notche is in for him. He's got some big shoes to fill, but he's one of the up and coming guys in South African rugby as well, so it's kind of good for him to get some experience in a game where they're kind of on a high, and there should be kind of a positive around the camp. The midfield's changed, so it's Esterhazen and Creel instead of Delander and So it's a big change there, although Creel did come in from the wing in that last game back into the midfield. Cheslin Colby is out on the right wing. LaRue, who was initially rumoured to not be going to come back for these last two games, his boss over at Wasps kind of said, yeah, if he's going to go, I can't keep him. So he's back. There was initially talks that due to his contract, he was not going to play the last two games, but he's back, and that's very important for South Africa because he's a key kind of playmaker and everything they do. On the bench, you've got Van Staden, which is cool because he's looked really good from what we've seen of him. Papia, who never seems to get any minutes. Nobody gets any minutes. It's always Faf de Klerk for the 80, so I wouldn't expect him to come on. Although now that I've said that, he probably will, because the last three times anyone's been on the bench behind Faf de Klerk, they haven't come on. And excitingly, Damian Willems is on the bench, so hopefully we'll get to see him with a few minutes under his belt as well. For the Wallabies, there's also a few changes. It has been disappointing so far. They aren't really yet to click. The front row is Sio Tatafu Polata now, and Taniela Tupou gets his first start, so it is going to be the Beast on one side up against Tongan Thor on the other. It's a good matchup, kind of young versus old. Both very exciting players, though, so we'll see how that battle goes at scrum time. Coleman starts, so Rory Arnold's back on the bench. Lucan Tui, after that kind of death in his family and that incident with the fan, you know, he's called it quits for this year with the Wallabies, so he is out. Ned Hannigan's going to be playing on the blind side. So that back row is Hannigan at 6, Hooper at 7, and Pocock at 8. So that Pocock and Hooper combination is back. It's not been seen for a couple of weeks, with both Pocock and Hooper being out for weeks 3 and 4. But it's interesting, though, because Pete Samu is not on the bench. So the forward cover, aside from the front row, is Arnold and Simmons. So neither of them is a loose forward. So how things work with the loosies is going to be interesting. Perhaps Hannigan, Hooper, and Prokak are expected to go the full 80, or perhaps you know, one of the locks is going to have to move out into the back row. So I guess we'll see how that goes. Folau continues on the right wing, so Dane Hewlett-Petty is in at fullback. Despite all that talk about Folau not passing in that last game, he still managed to you know, do some damage from the right wing. So forgetting that one incident, he's still going to be a danger man for the Wallabies. You got to think, after that big win over the All Blacks, there's a huge bit of pressure on the box not to lose at home to the Wallabies, because you've just beaten the best in the world away, so in New Zealand. If you go, then go home and lose to a team which is now 7th, because they've swapped 5th and 7th places around, it's going to be a big come down. So the media in South Africa, I know they can be pretty brutal, have kind of been a wee bit hands-off of Rassie and his guys since that big victory over the All Blacks, but I have a feeling that will be very short-lived if they lose this next game. So there is immense pressure on them to get a win at home. Perhaps not as much expectation on the Wallabies to get a win away, but there's definitely pressure, because this record of 1-3 is not a great one. And after losing at home, there's definitely no guarantees they will go into Argentina and get a result. So yeah, there's huge pressure on both teams to win. The Box haven't lost to the Wallabies in South Africa since 2011, although there has been that draw last year, so it's going to be an interesting one. There's huge pressure, as I said. The bookies have got the Box by 8 points, so still picking it to be fairly tight. I guess we will see how things go. How do you guys see this one going? Have a look at the teams, have a look at the benches. How do you think things are going to play out? Do you think 8 points is a pretty fair margin? How do you think it's going to go? Who are you excited to see? And who are you kind of disappointed to see out? But yeah, you guys let me know your thoughts. And yeah, we'll see how things go. I'll talk to you again soon. See you later.